Balance. Balance is the distribution and placement of elements in a composition relative to their visual weight in the design. In this poster, the balance is obvious. The structure on the left is balancing the structure on the right, and the focal point, the actor James Franco in this case, is put right in the middle. Notice that the text is also centered to augment the balance of the photography. Asymmetrical balance. Some designs appear balanced despite a lack of symmetry. This house is not symmetrical. The right side of the house is taller and less wide than the left side of the house. However, due to the different methods of construction, the wood on the right and the composite on the left, the design itself feels balanced. It doesn't feel like one side of the house is dominating over the other. So balance can be created symmetrically or asymmetrically. Consistency. The selection of design elements that have similar attributes to create an overarching structure. With FedEx's various logos, the use of consistency is obvious. There's consistency in the topography. There's consistency in the positioning. But color is changed from one logo to the next to give variation. But consistency gives the set of logos order and gives you the idea that they are all related to each other. Here's the Coca-Cola logo in several different languages. Even though the alphabets and letter forms are completely different, you can still see the consistency. The consistency exists in the red color, but also in the type forms themselves. Contrast. Contrast is obvious differences in elements within a composition. Those differences can be size, form, color, weight, texture, or symmetry. In this poster from the movie Devil's Puppet, there's a huge contrast between the red and the black. That's augmented by a white background and white and black shoes on the central focus of this particular poster. There's other items of contrast as well. Notice the font used for the actual name of the movie versus the font of the type below it. You can also see some contrast in size of the primary character and the character standing in his hand. Contrast is something that can make designs very interesting. Here's another example of contrast. The title of this article is Men Are Men. The giant characters used to form the word men contrast with the smaller characters in the actual title on the left-hand side of the page. Notice also the thin characters and thick characters and how they're used together. On the left-hand side, number 37 is in extremely thin characters, while the typeface for Men Are Men is thicker. The contrast between white and black here also works to make this design interesting. Here's another photograph that makes good use of contrast. The oranges contrast not only with the tone of the model's skin, but also the blue background. Essentially, you can say this design is made from three separate colors, even though there's variations within those colors. The contrast also sends an interesting yet subtle message in this photo. Line. A line is the connection between points. We probably take lines for granted, but they can be a very useful design element. Notice how line is used in this Vermont Symphony Orchestra poster. While the line does form a grid, the actual typography doesn't follow the grid. The line is simply a design element. Here's a more creative use of line. Line is generally used to guide the eye within a design. If you look at the various lines coming from the central text, the words unspooling, you can see it guides the eyes to several different features of this poster. It guides the eyes to the words artists and cinema. It guides the eyes to the dates of the performance and the names of the cast members. Line can be an extremely useful design element when you're trying to feature an element within a design. Negative space. The area around the elements on a page, sometimes known as white space. I would argue white space doesn't necessarily have to be white. It is the empty area within a design. And many will tell you that the negative space is as important as the positive space or the actual elements you're featuring within a page. This advertisement for Piaget watches makes very good use of negative space. Beginning designers feel the compulsion to fill a page with content and different elements. I would argue that the restrained use of content and more use of negative space can make a more interesting and exciting design. Perhaps the masters of negative space in design are Apple. Apple has always used loads of negative space in their design to very dramatic effect. In this design, advertising the iPhone 7, it's the negative space that makes this actual web page striking. The phone itself is simply an element existing in the negative space. The contrast between the negative space, the white text, and the black background makes this a powerful design. The minimalist movement is becoming increasingly popular again, and the minimalist movement is all about negative space. Notice how the negative empty space in this particular design makes an interesting statement. Notice how the calendar on the right-hand side, using only the colors black and white, makes the negative space on the left that much more pronounced. Point. A point is a single dot on a page. It is the smallest possible element in a design. When you use points in a design, it's important to remember the rule of closure. The viewer's brain will connect the actual points, making a solid figure. Here, even though it's just a series of dots, you can tell that this design is a representation of a world map. Proximity. Relation created between elements due to their location near each other within a composition. Focus on the text of the cover of this Essence magazine. Notice that different typefaces and colors are used for related text elements, but proximity lets you know that those elements belong together. The article on Vanessa and Jillian, and the text, "Mom and Daughter Dish on Loving Ourselves at Every Age." It is proximity that links the two text elements here. Same with New Year's special, Eat Your Way to Prosperity. Even though contrasting typefaces and colors are used, proximity links the different pieces of text. Here's a representation of a digital sign. Proximity is used in several different ways here. When you're organizing a lot of information in a single design, proximity might be one of the only tools you have to create relationships between text. On the right-hand side, the graphic providing service status on the tube makes good use of proximity. Repetition. The repeated use of the same design elements or aspects of those elements in a composition. Here you can see two individual ads from Target. The use of repetition is obvious with the dots and the actual Target logo. However, it's important to remember that repetition can also occur between designs, and that repetition can help create a brand. There's also a number of elements here that are repeated that are not so obvious. Notice that both models are dressed in complete white outfits. Notice that both models are partially behind and partially in front of the other design elements. Notice the bottom model appears to be blowing into a horn, the end of which looks a lot like a dot from the top advertisement. Here are several different logos from British Rail. Again, repetition is extremely important in linking these and making them cohesive.